What's up, everyone? Welcome to my channel. This is my 03 Mercury Marauder. It is a V8 4.6 automatic, just over 100,000 miles. I've had it for probably about 8 months now, and it has been a very solid car. I am actually a GM guy, but I've had a thing for these for quite some time. Over the years, I've had a couple run-ins with some on the road with other cars of mine, and they've all been a pretty good run. I haven't had one that was able to outrun some of my Camaros and stuff, but I was definitely a fan of them from the start. This particular one is number 2537 out of 7,838 and is 2,537 of 7,093 manufactured in black. It was built at the St. Thomas Assembly on July 19th of 2002, even though it is an 03 model year. If you're not aware of that, they typically build cars the year before, starting the model year early. But this is her in all her glory. Most of them were black. Very few were silver, red, or that deep blue. The car has 106,000 miles on it. When I first bought it, it was just at 100,000. There's your odometer. So far, it's been a great car. I've put 6,000 miles on it in that time. That's more miles than I've put on anything else in the last 10 years, if that tells you how much I like driving it. This particular car, everything works. The air conditioning is fantastic. The air ride feels great. The steering is fantastic. This is an original, pretty much Florida car. It was bought and basically sent here within a month of its first purchase of its owner. So it has spent its whole life in Central Florida, near the Orlando area. I got it off the second owner. He took great care of it. He owned an automotive shop, so he was constantly having things done to it just to keep it up and maintain it. There's really no body damage. I do believe it's been probably repainted at one time, and just the top part of the car, I don't even think it's been an entire paint. But it looks great. I would say the paint's about a 9 out of 10. The interior is just as great a shape. It definitely is one of the smoothest cars I've ever owned. Here is the 4.6, 32 valve V8. Produces all of about 330 foot-pounds of torque, and I think 300 horsepower. Don't quote me on that. I never really dug into it. I didn't feel like the car was actually a bullet to begin with, so I didn't really dig for horsepower numbers. I just kind of based me purchasing this car off of looks alone. This is the biggest motor you could get in them, and your Crown Vics, your Lincoln Town Cars, and your Grand Marquis did not actually come with that motor. They actually came with something similar. It was a 4.6, but it was a single overhead cam. This is a dual overhead cam. I had actually considered purchasing a 96 Chevy Impala Super Sport and was looking at some, but didn't quite find what I wanted. This car seemed to be more up my alley. It was super clean, low owner, Central Florida car, like I'd stated, but everything worked. Everything was well taken care of. And the person I got it from definitely appreciated it. He gave me a stack of paperwork with this thing from day one. My kids fit well in the back. Let me unlock this. I needed a family car because everything else I have is pretty much two-door or does not have a back seat. And I just wanted a cool family car. Everybody's got an SUV, which I'm not against SUVs. My wife has a Denali. It's a great car or truck, but I wanted something unique, something you don't see every day, something that's different, so I went with this. I also considered the purchasing a CTSV, but I couldn't find the CTSV I wanted. And this car popped up. It was about the cleanest one. And I had considered even driving out west to get one and making a trip out of it and bringing it home, but it just wasn't something that I needed to do when I found something so nice right in my back door. Plus, I didn't want to travel, you know, 2,500 miles to find out I was looking at a car that just wasn't taken care of, because it's hard to tell online sometimes. As far as future plans go, I really don't have anything crazy. I would love to supercharge it. I don't know if I will. I will say that out of all my cars, this is the one I drive the most. I don't plan on getting rid of it. I also have a 04 Mach 1. That car is very similar in a lot of ways as far as engine drivetrain to this. Obviously, it's a little bit quicker to drive because it weighs less. But I wouldn't mind supercharging this, doing some work to it, maybe doing some different wheels down the road just to kind of change it up a little bit. I don't really have any intentions of getting rid of the car. I would like a CTSV at some point, but I'm very happy with this. I don't see me getting rid of the car. And like I said, it's hard to find them. I do wish it was an 04. I wanted an 04 because my Mach 1 was an 04. And I wanted a sunroof, but oh well. I settled for this, and I don't feel like it was a bad choice at all. Since buying this, I've probably only seen two or three others. And every time I see one, it kind of makes me glad I went ahead and bought one of these. I do feel like the value on them is going to go up at some point. It is a two-year only. They did come with the dual exhaust out of the back. The spoiler, I believe, was just added later. If there was anything I guess I would change about this is just the sunroof itself. I would like to have a sunroof on it. All right, we're going to go ahead and start it up. One of the great things about this is when I purchased the car, I got three sets of keys with it and found this nifty keychain online as well. I think it's just for an older Mercury key, but anyway. All the gauges work. Very happy about that. I would like to upgrade those, put some better lights behind it. One of the things I do like is the overhead console. Not a lot of cars have those, and it definitely makes for a better storage compartment, because I do like to keep stuff in the center console as well. But I'm 6'4" and I fit comfortably in it. Obviously they're big cars, so that makes sense, but the seats in them are unique to the Marauder itself, and they actually have some engraving in it. So recently I told you I'd taken the car to, oh look, there's a deer. When there's one down here, there's usually three or four. So we'll just take it slow. Not that I feel like a deer would hurt this car as bad as the car would hurt the deer. Anyway, so recently I had mentioned I had taken the car for a trip. I had actually left Central Florida myself and drove all the way up to North Carolina. And I was concerned because the car, when I bought it 8 months ago, the tires on it were pretty much brand new, but they were old. They had not had any miles put on them. The person who purchased the vehicle before me had actually got it off the original owner, who put brand new tires on it, and the tires are dated from 2016. Yeah, I took a risk. Let me put this seatbelt on. Yeah, I took a risk. Steel belted radials are nothing to mess with for sure, especially with age, and it could have probably been an issue. But I made the entire trip and nothing ever happened. It was actually a really nice trip. I told my dad, who went with me, I think that was one of the best choices, was bringing this car, because we had thought about taking this truck. We had hit some pretty twisty roads. The roads were pretty curvy. If you've been to North Carolina, you know that it's very windy roads through the mountains. And I actually, that was the only thing I was disappointed about with this car going through those roads, was because the car seemed like I needed to kind of oversteer in order for me to get through the curve the way I wanted to get through the curve. Me being used to driving other cars, like some of my other cars, you know, the Mustang, the Corvettes, my Camaros. Just recently, I had an SRT4 that I had sold. But all of those cars, it didn't feel like I needed to steer much in order to get through a curve. This car, it felt like I really had to oversteer. My other issue is the rearview mirror kind of blinds my line of sight when coming out of a curve. So if I was coming out of a curve that had an elevation behind it, it was hard for me to see to make sure that there wasn't oncoming traffic in my lane, because up there people like to cross the line while they're coming around them curves. And it was hard for me to see if another car was coming around the curve since I was going through there. And I didn't care for that. But those were really the only two complaints I had. The car got about 25 miles to the gallon on the first tank on the way up, and it got about 26 miles to the gallon on the way back heading south. So I was kind of impressed with that. The last couple of times I took a vehicle to North Carolina, they got less than 15 miles to the gallon. So taking something like this during a time where gas, which I have to get 93 in this car, it's not a car you want to run 87 or 89, and it's a car you want to run 93 in. So getting 93 octane, or premium fuel as the gauge cluster calls it, was about $5 a gallon in that area until we got into Georgia. When we got into Georgia, the cost of fuel was much cheaper, and then we bought fuel in the north side of Georgia coming out of North Carolina on the way back. And I was impressed. 26 miles to the gallon on the way back and 25 on the way there from such a big, heavy car. One of the reasons I do like these so much is because it's one of the last versions of the true American family car. Rear-wheel drive, big, four-door, V8, and it's just a tank. These things live forever. The police departments use them. Taxi services use them. Military uses them, Secret Service uses them, FBI. They all go to one of these cars for basically the workhorse and the longevity. I've seen some of these cars get around 500,000 miles out of them before actually basically trying to give up. They were just too tired. Will the transmission and engine last that long? I feel like it absolutely would if you take care of it and maintain it. I would like to find another one to kind of build, maybe like somewhat of a project Marauder, but they're not that easy to find, and unfortunately we're in a time where everything is way more expensive than it was a year ago, so the value of these cars have extremely climbed over the last year, and kind of hoping for it to come back down so I can get another one. I wouldn't mind a Crown Vic or a Grand Marquis, but Marauder's kind of more up my alley as far as performance goes, so if I could find another one, that would be awesome. Well, that about wraps it up for this video. This is my 03 Mercury Marauder. Definitely one of the best cars I've had. Very happy with it. I don't plan on getting rid of it. I do enjoy it. My family likes riding in it. I have full faith in it going long distance, and even just running to the store and stuff, it's so convenient because of the amount of room. This will not be my last video on it. I will have more. Like I said, there are a couple of things I would like to do. The Mach 1 chin spoiler that's on this was one of the things I had planned on doing when I was going to buy one. And this one already had it. The only other thing that was really ever changed on the car was it had drilled and slotted rotors and new brakes and calipers when I got it. So that was nice, so I didn't have to worry about doing the brakes anytime soon. I hope to, at some point, maybe get some more horsepower out of it. I would like to contact Marty and get the tune done for the car, but it rides so nice now, I'm pretty happy with it. I don't have to run out and get that stuff right away. At some point, I will probably put it on a lift so I can get a video of the bottom of the car. I've actually not spent really much any time under the car. When I checked it out when I first bought it, just to make sure it wasn't rusted, and there wasn't any issues or anything hanging, and everything was clean as a whistle under there. So at some point I'll get it up on my lift so we can take a look at the bottom of the car. But thank you for checking out my video. If you enjoyed it or you want to see other videos, make sure you like and subscribe, and if you have any questions, just put it down in the comments. Thanks.
Step to the ride, let's glide for the night. Yeah, we gon' party on Sunset. Living the Hollywood life.